वेलकम टू द ई लर्निंग सेशन ऑफ मिसेलिनियस ग्राम नेगेटिव बैक्टीरिया पार्ट वन। इन दिस लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट द मिसेलिनियस ग्राम नेगेटिव बैक्टीरिया। सो हियर इज द लिस्ट ऑफ द बैक्टीरिया दैट वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस इन टुडेज लेक्चर। द फर्स्ट वन इज अ शिगेला, देन क्लेप्सिला, प्रोटियस, सुडोमोनास, बर्खोल्डेरिया and last the Acinetobacter. So let us first talk about the Shigella. So let us start with the Shigella. Why it is important? Because it is a causative agent of bacillary dysentery. Bacillary dysentery means there is a diarrhea with mucus and blood. We can differentiate bacillary dysentery from amoebic dysentery. The causative agent of amoebic dysentery is Entamoeba histolytica parasite. Shigella is a gram-negative facultative anaerobic rods. It is oxidase negative. It is a non-motile and it can give the non-lactose fermenting colonies on Meconcis agar. Here is the classification of the Shigella. Based on somatic or polysaccharide antigen, Shigella species are divided into the four groups. The first one is Shigella dysentery. Shigella dysentery is most, it can cause the most severe infections. The other one is Shigella flexneri. The infection of this Shigella flexneri, it is present into the developing countries. Shigella boidi is very rare species. And at last, Shigella soni. Infection of this bacteria is present in developed countries. Now the pathogenesis part. Infection of this Shigella is occurred by the fecal route. So here is the Shiga toxin which is produced by the Shigella. There is a two fragment of this toxin, one is A and other is B. So fragment B is bind with this GB3 receptor and fragment A inhibits the 28S subunit of 60S ribosomes and at last it inhibit the protein synthesis. This is how there is a cell death occurs due to the Shiga toxin. And there is, now we are going to talk about the clinical disease. So there are few phases of this. The first one is the initial phase where patient comes with watery diarrhea, fever, malaise, anorexia and vomiting. Then there is a dysentery phase where patient comes with dysentery. So dysentery means bloody mucopurulent diarrhea and also there is an increasing amount of abdominal cramps. This dysentery is going to be complicated and it will form as a hemolytic colitis and hemolytic uremic syndrome. Laboratory diagnosis. So first of all, specimen collection. So we can collect the specimens like stool, mucus flakes and rectal swabs. Then microscopy. So you can do the microscopy of weight mount preparation of stool, where you can observe the pus cells and RBCs. Then cultures, you can use selenite F broth for transport medium. You can use Meconcis agar, DCA agar and SS agar for isolation of this Shigella. DCA means deoxycholate citrate agar and SS means Shigella salmonella agar. These are the special medias for Shigella. Identification. Identification is done by the smear. First of all, you can see the gram-negative bacilli in the gram stain. There is these bacteria are non-motile and you can differentiate the different species with the help of biochemical reaction and slide agglutination test. So according to the slide agglutination test, you can divide the Shigella into the four major groups, group A, B, C and D. Group A means Shigella dysentery, group B means Shigella flexneri, group C means Shigella boidi, and group D means Shigella shoni. So this is about the Shigella. Now we are going to talk about the Klebsiella. Klebsiella is a gram-negative, facultative anaerobic rods, but there is a presence of capsule here. It is oxidase negative, it is non-motile, and gives the lactose fermenting colonies on Meckonkhi's agar. So there is a pinkish color colonies on Meckonkhi's agar. It is usually commensal in human intestine, but it can also cause the severe infections. There is a two medically important species. One is Klebsiella pneumoniae, another is Klebsiella oxytoca. Then the clinical manifestation. It can cause the severe lobar pneumonia, urinary tract infection, meningitis, septicemia, and hospital acquired infection. So now you may have the question, what is hospital acquired? So the hospital acquired infection, or we can say the nosocomial infection, or we can say the healthcare associated infection, is the infection acquired into the hospital by patient who was admitted for a reason other than that infection, and this infection was not present or in incubating state at the time of admission. That means if patient comes with a stroke in ICU and he develops the catheter associated urinary tract infection. So this catheter associated urinary tract infection is hospital acquired infection. So this infection he or she might get from the ICU, environment of the ICU. Okay, so there are four major types of the hospital acquired infection. The first one is CAUTI, that is catheter associated urinary tract infection. Second one is CLABSI, that means central line associated bloodstream infection. The third one is SSI, that means surgical site infection. And the fourth one is VAP, that is ventilator associated pneumonia. And laboratory diagnosis of infection of Klebsiella. So first of all, you can do the gram stain. So in the gram stain, you can see there is a short but capsulated gram negative bacilli. Here you can see the capsulated gram negative bacilli. And you can also do the culture on Meckonkhi's agar, where you can see the pinkish color lactose fermenting large dome shaped colonies. There is a keynote picture of this Klebsiella, so it can show the mucoid colonies due to the presence of the capsule. You can see there is a mucoid colonies here on Meckonkhi's agar. Then the proteus. Proteus is named after the Greek god Proteus, who was able to assume any shapes. So it is the pleomorphic type of bacteria. It is also a gram-negative coccobacilli. It shows the swarming on blood agar. You can see the swarming. There is a swarm growth of bacteria on the blood agar. It can also give the fishy odor. There are two medically important species. One is Proteus mirabilis, another is Proteus vulgaris. Proteus is an opportunistic pathogen. It is commonly associated with urinary tract infection, wound and soft tissue infections, and septicemia. It can also cause the hospital acquired infection. Now the important organism, Pseudomonas. Pseudomonas is a gram-negative bacilli. It is the organism that can be present into a hospitalized patient. It is obligate aerobe, that means it can only grow if there is a presence of oxygen. It is oxidase positive and actively motile. And there is a keynote feature or characteristic feature of the Pseudomonas that it can produce the pigment, that means a color. You can see there are four types of pigment that is produced by the Pseudomonas. So first one is pyocyanin. Pyocyanin, that means a greenish blue color type of pigment that is produced by the Pseudomonas aeruginosa. You can see in the picture. Then the second pigment is pyoverdin, that means greenish yellow color. Then pyoruby, that is red color. And last, the pyomelanin, that is brownish black color colonies. Clinical disease. So it can cause the two variety of the disease. One is hospital acquired infection, another is community acquired infection. In the hospital acquired infection, there is a ventilator associated pneumonia and septicemia. And in the community acquired infection, there is infective endocarditis, especially in IV drug abusers. It can also cause the infection of ear. The infections are either mild, such as swimmer's ear, or serious, such as malignant otitis externa. Eye infections like keratitis and corneal ulcer, you can see in the picture. Shanghai fever, which is mild febrile illness like typhoid fever. Skin infections. Pseudomonas is the most common organism to infect the burn wounds. Then we are going to talk about the laboratory diagnosis of this infection caused by Pseudomonas. So first of all, specimen collection. So depend upon the site, you can collect the pus, wound swab, sputum, blood or urine. In the microscopy, you can see the gram-negative bacilli in the gram stain. Then culture. There is a greenish color pigment and metallic sheen which is present in the case of Pseudomonas aeruginosa on the nutrient agar. And the lactose non-fermenting colonies, that is a pale color in on the Mekonki's agar. Then biochemical reaction. Pseudomonas is an oxidase positive as well as the catalase positive. And then at last, antibiotic sensitivity test. Pseudomonas possesses a number of drug resistance plasmid. That's why it produces the ESBLN carbapenemase enzymes. Now we are going to talk about the Burkholderia. Burkholderia is a gram-negative bacilli and oxidase positive, like the Pseudomonas. So now you may have a question how we can differentiate Burkholderia from Pseudomonas. So with the help of bipolar stained gram-negative bacilli. So you can see there is a bipolar stain, or we can also use or we can also call it a ceftibin like appearance. It is a resistant to polymyxin B. Burkholderia can be used as a potential agent of bioterrorism. Burkholderia having a two major species, Burkholderia pseudomallei and Burkholderia mallei. Burkholderia pseudomallei can cause the melioidosis and Burkholderia mallei can cause the glanders. This glanders can be present into a horse. Glanders means there is a nasal discharge and ulcer in nasal septum. Then Acinetobacter. Acinetobacter is a gram-negative coccobacilli. It is oxidase negative. Lactose non-fermenter, that means it can show a pale colony on Mekonki's agar. Acinetobacter is a saprophytic bacilli which is present into a hospital environment. There are three important species. The first one is Acinetobacter baumannii, then second one is Acinetobacter loafi, and the third one is Acinetobacter calcoaceticus. Among this, Acinetobacter baumannii is very important because it can cause the hospital acquired infection, while Acinetobacter loafi can cause the community acquired infections. So this is about the different gram-negative bacilli. So this is the part one. I hope you can like it. Thank you.